Hi guys, the name is Mark, and we're just going to do a quick little video here. And basically, it's going to go like this, okay, guys? If you've applied, we're going to pretend this is a birth certificate, okay? So if you guys have applied for a birth certificate, you've lied to state that you're this person, okay? So thus, you thus then become this person. So effectively, what's happening is people have applied to be this person, say your name, right? And basically what they're doing is they're giving up their licenses and stuff, but they still have the person. They're still in charge of this person, right? So effectively what's happening is they're running around, they're giving up their licenses and stuff, and they want to have one foot in Canada and they want to have one foot on the lawful side. Now, lawful and legal don't mix, okay? People, legal, gal is French for woman, right? Hence, prostitution was the oldest form of trade or business. Hence, so basically, it was considered legal if you took her out, say, for dinner or breakfast or whatever. And where would you take a hoe? Well, you'd take her to a hotel. So you can see where I'm going with this. So what's happening, people, is the birth certificate is the subject matter of all legislation. So if you're in possession of one of these, okay, basically what's happening is, don't you dare run around and state that you're not this person and that you are entitled to travel lawfully, right? Because lawful and legal don't mix. That's like mixing oil and water, okay? So basically, that's why it's considered illegal if you have a person to travel. So basically, in a nutshell, people, the birth certificate is the subject matter of all legislation. So if you've applied and agreed to be this person, then don't think you're going to give up your license and then have a right to travel. That would make you basically a moron. Actually, it'd make you a less on. But anyhow, people, you can see where I'm going with this. So the bottom line is, if you've applied to state that you're this person, don't you think that you have the right to travel even if you don't have a license? It's just that simple. I was talking to some people, and I'm not going to mention some names, and I'm like, the fine is probably $100,000+ in debt, and $100,000, the charge, is a lot of time in jail, okay? So basically what's happening is people are running around, they're applying to state that they're this person, this is a birth certificate, and then they're going to court and they're saying, well, I'm not that person. Even in their world, that is fraud, people, okay? So the bottom line is this. If you've applied to state that you're this person, whether you have a social insurance number or not, you have a license or not, well, you've agreed to be this person. So you better darn well go out and get yourself a license. Don't think that you're going to go traveling. So anyhow, people, it's that simple. You can either have a covenant with man, which is all these rules, bylaws, and he who buys the law makes the laws, right? And it's just that simple, people. So till then, you know, if you've agreed to be this person and the officer asks for ID, well, be sure to give them ID. You've agreed to their rules and regulations, bylaws, statutes, and acts. Otherwise, if you have not agreed to this person and you've sent back the birth certificate with your social insurance number, your passports, the whole nine yards, well, then you have the grace of God, okay? So you can have a covenant with man. Rights can be given by men. They can be taken by man. Right? Or you can deal with the grace of God, forget about rights, and effectively then you're free, so long as you cause nobody harm whatsoever. It's just that simple, people. See how much easier the laws are if you're not a person with all page after page and bookshelf after bookshelf of laws and statutes and acts. You can't even keep up. But once you give that all back and you say, I'm no longer this person, and all licenses, birth certificate, it's all been revoked, social insurance number, you're out of the sinners program, hence SIN, short for social insurance number, then you're free to have the grace of God and you don't need 10,000 laws, bylaws, rules, regs. It's just that simple, people, okay? So until then, please keep your heads up and your sticks on the ice, okay? Peace, love.